assuming, Dominic, that the next Prime Minister is a much more ardent Brexiter and less sort of stuck in the middle than Theresa May was accused of being. And after the summer recess, there are only 22 parliamentary days before the extension of October 31st that the European Union has given the UK. Mm. Does it, do you think, automatically follow that the UK is headed for a hard out of the European Union?
I don't think it necessarily automatically follows, but I do think the odds of no deal have risen with Theresa May stepping down. I think, firstly, the obvious window in terms of the timetable to get the deal through was the month of June, and now that's just going to be swallowed up by the Conservative Party leadership contest. And as you say, once we get back from the summer recess, there's not an awful lot of time left. I imagine that if there is a hard Brexiteer candidate, they might not necessarily kind of directly go for no deal, but they would perhaps say, we want to renegotiate the deal, and then if that doesn't work, go to no deal.
So that end, they'd have to ask the European Union for another extension to get it all done. Is that what you mean?
I think perhaps they would go down that route, yes. But whether the European Union would grant an extension on those grounds is another matter entirely. I think they would be more likely to go for an extension if there was a general election on the cards.
But could a hard Brexit to Prime Minister just ignore Parliament and just say, well, you know, you can vote on whatever you like. We're out on the 31st and that's it.
So I think the mechanisms available to Parliament for trying to prevent no deal are much less robust now than they were back in February and March. So a lot of the, you know, for example, if a Brexiteer Prime Minister isn't trying to get a deal through, then Parliament can't, there is nothing for Parliament to amend to try and block no deal and signal its disapproval. So, but I think the ultimate weapon that Parliament still would have is a vote of no confidence that would bring about a general election.
And would also create constitutional chaos in the country, wouldn't it?
Absolutely, yeah. There's a question of who would go to the EU and ask for an extension if the Prime Minister doesn't want one.
It's ever so complicated. I mean, this whole bloodletting process was supposed to make things simpler for the Conservative Party. Do you think that the next Prime Minister, whoever it is basically going to face exactly the same problems that Theresa May had?
I don't think they'll face exactly the same problems, because I think part of the problem that Theresa May has faced is that her party has wanted to get rid of her and that her party is internally divided. And I think potentially a new leader may not face that to the same degree, but they will face two fundamental constraints that have dogged the entire Brexit process. Firstly, that the EU does not want to renegotiate the deal, and secondly, that there is no parliamentary majority for anything, including no deal, but also including a second referendum and various alternative deals.
Yeah. Okay, Dominic, thank you very much indeed for your time. Well, the next step after.